Hello everyone, welcome to part 14 of my Neverwhere project on city skylines. And here, from the brilliantly obvious suggestions department, you build your sewage and effluent pipes downstream from where you're getting your fresh water, from the no-duh department. But then I'm sure some people just don't think about it. Okay, now I can't remember what I was doing last time around here. I expanded the office area here, and I linked up the highway, I think. Right. Okay. So, I'm closing in on 100,000 citizens. Now, let's see here. What's the demographics look like? Yeah, not so good. See, it's this number compared to this number. Yeah, I'd like to see these numbers higher and this one lower, but... You know, that's what happens when you have these adults eventually become seniors, and eventually the seniors die, right? So, if you get top heavy here, obviously the death rate's going to be higher than the birth rate for a while. Okay. Okay, so realistically, I got to stop saying that, realistically. Yeah, I'm waiting for someone to leave a comment on one of the videos saying, realistically, you keep using that word. I do not think it means what you think it means. Well, it means exactly what I think it means. Doesn't mean I'm using it right. Okay. So I have demand for commercial and industrial. Okay. Now let's... Well, if I do this, I can see what I've zoned where. Okay, so this is mostly residential. Okay, so I have a freight station over here and one over here. Let's see. I have offices here. I think what I'll do is fill in some of this area this time around. And while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to set me a timer. So I don't end up running 3 hours with this part. Okay, I'm going to start by putting my main road across here. And I'm going to put an interchange here. Oh, right. Okay, so that means when I build the stuff in here, there will be an outlet. Now, you know what? I'm going to make this a big road all the way across. Course, I could have built it this way in the first place, but meh, you know. People, right? Now, okay, so now I need some side roads. I'm going to leave a fair gap here, but I'm still going to build grid wise. So can hear all the dinging sounds of things upgrading. I'll put my first road here. Okay. Okay. Yes, I know that grids are boring. But they're also efficient. And quite easy to build. Okay. Okay, so that gives me a road network in there. Now I need to put some pipes. Okay, so that's pipes. Okay, now I'm going to make a halfway connection here. The pedestrians will probably like that connection. Okay. Now, I have, of course, I must have neglected to finish building this path. Where was it? It was going over here. Oh, I probably clobbered it with this. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to move that over a couple of... No, I need to go to... Okay. I should actually finish my... pathway thing here. Okay. Looks ridiculous, but I think it works. And What's this? Okay. Already occupied. Right, okay, I think that'll do. Ah, I did bring the path in that way. Okay. Now that I've made everyone dizzy twirling the display around. I'm going to start with some offices here. And along the highway. And the edges. Now, I'm going to add in some services. Now, what do I need here? I definitely need some parks. And again, I really like these Japanese Zen garden things. Because they're only 4x4 and they fit just about anywhere. Without causing any space constraints. Okay. Now, I'm going to put some low density commercial in here. And the rest can be offices. Okay, now let's see what happens. Now, I'll need to put some transit in here, of course, but first I need to work out just what I need in here. See, I'm running a budget deficit right now. Come on. This will work better when somebody builds something in the right place to link the power up. Is that close enough? Yes, it is. I'm going to speed things up here. I'm also going to put sound walls on this stretch of highway here. Since I've got the development right up against the highway here, it's really only nice to the tenants there that you reduce the noise somewhat. Now, with this development here so far, I haven't managed to create a traffic nightmare. I've still got heavy traffic over here, but that's not surprising. There's some pretty crazy traffic setups here, but you know, to be honest, I've seen some really crazy stuff in real life driving too. It's kind of funny, you know, I'm down to part 14 and I'm finally back to my original. Here's my original development tile. And now I'm back into this area. Okay, so now it's time to look into bus operation here. Okay, so no, I'm not going to do that. Okay, that's a line going that way. Now I most always do the lines going both directions. That's because, well, it's annoying for users to have to go around the long way just to get to just to go like three stops. They're gonna walk instead. I'm also going to add a metro extension round about here. Actually, no. I'm going to move it round about here. Right, okay. Reason I did that is because it's closer to the bus stop. Now, I need to link it up. And we come over to this stop. And we come back over to this stop. Okay, so that gives me I'll probably have to rejigger that at some point, but theoretically that means the pedestrians coming from the metro station don't need to cross the big street. What I should do is fix the hole in the zoning I made here. What I don't get about traffic light setups in a lot of these games is how they put the traffic light standard facing the traffic on the near side of the intersection. I don't get that because if you're if the stop line is here, you can't actually see the light from your car. Or at least you have to look straight up to see it. Not exactly friendly. And most places I've been, the traffic light is either suspended over the middle of the intersection on a wire or on the other side of it, facing the traffic. And that's generally, I believe, to give a better line of sight for it. Anyway. Let's see here. Do I have some... I have, not enough workers. Oh, that went away? No, it's still there. So, what I'm going to do now... I don't actually have a real demand for residential, though. I'm going to... build out a little bit here. I guess I'll go up to the next grid here with this one. Okay, and bring this one down. It'd be nice if you didn't have to build every intersection directly, if you could just go straight across and the game would figure it out. And here I just had the wrong road type selected. I really wanted the tree-lined roads here. It's easy enough to fix, especially when you have enough cash to basically, you know, buy out Midas. Okay. Now, I'm going to build some education and a couple of traditional parks. And I guess some water, because, you know, people like their water for some reason. Okay, so far so good. Now, I'm going to make this residential. Well, you know what? I'll put commercial on the main road here. Now, I'm definitely going to want one of these in here. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay. Okay, that's a link up. Okay, there we go. Okay, I would think theoretically with residential nearby the not enough workers thing should start to resolve. Of course, with low unemployment, it may not. Oh, and while I wasn't looking, I've broken 100,000 citizens here. Okay, I'm going to, just for fun, build a train terminal over here. Oh, right, I need to build a road first. Okay, now I can go and build my train terminal, which will be about here. Course, now I need to get a track to it. Actually, wait, well, I could come along here. Yeah, I think that'll work. Okay. So, let's put that back to a normal speed. So I'll come up to here, and now I'll go all curly here. Okay, there. Okay. Okay. That's a crazy path for a train. Okay. There's probably a better way to do that, but there we go. Okay. Right, I'm going to turn these into ramps. That way, if I do get any amount of traffic going here, now let's speed that up and see if anything does come. I figure over here I'll build either some industrial or commercial or a combination. And when I do that, it'll be good having a cargo station there. I see there's a train connection over here, so I should actually acquire that plot. So that I can build a connection there. So I can use this as a transfer station, actually. So if I build... Oh, right, I'm going to have to turn that into a proper road to do that. Right. Now, I can turn this into a station here. And I'll need to do this. And water. Now, I have the excitement here of sending a rail line across the water over to the main line. Okay, so that gives me another outlet for freight. And that will pretty much guarantee these two stations get used. Well, there's freight being delivered over here anyway. So that's good. The commercial types will like that. Oh, right. Now that I've got that there, I can change this back to a highway road. The advantage of doing that is the traffic runs faster on it. Ah, there we go. There's an inbound train. And some of those trucks that are coming on the inbound trains are stopping at the other freight terminal. Now, that's a good thing. I may need to turn this into one of those monstrosity interchange things, but as long as I don't have a huge traffic bottleneck over here, I won't need to do that. Okay. So far, so good. My budget's gone to a surplus, so there's that. Okay. Now, how are the demographics doing? Lousy. I've got really low unemployment, and I have a demand for commercial. I'm going to... where is it? There it is. Oops, I need to actually build a road. So I'll fill in here. Okay, water. There we go. And I'll go for commercial here. And even here. I should probably have an interchange of some kind here. But I haven't decided what I need here yet. It'll depend on what I end up having to do here. Okay. Oh, my population's sliding back again. And it's probably due to the death rate. But not entirely, I don't think. Probably partly due to the unemployment rate. Anyway, let's check the other services. Electricity is okay for now, but it's getting on the edge. Water's okay for now. Education's okay. Yeah, education's okay. Traffic's not too bad. All in, it's not bad at all. That could be a lot worse. Okay, there's my transit network. Okay, I've got some lack of workers here. I'm not surprised by that. That's not bad. Some noise pollution going on, not surprising that. Okay. Okay, I'm done looking at that. Now, out of curiosity, how are these water pumps doing? Yeah, they're doing okay. I really should spread those out. It would be nice if I could turn off these clouds, but meh, I think I can live with that. Okay, so I'm starting to get some demand on residential back. That's a good sign. I should be able to extend the residential down this way, and that should clear up the remaining jobs issues there. Yeah, here was the edge of the of my original city tile. I should mention that I'm playing with the All Tiles Unlocked mod, which is how I'm able to get this tile, even though I already had 9 tiles in the city. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is number 10. Now, I upgraded my video card driver as well. It doesn't seem to have made all that much of a difference in the overall gameplay. Maybe it'll impact some of those weird black screen issues I've been having, but it's hard to say. And even if it does, I probably won't even notice. They weren't that common anyway. Okay, so from here, Okay, yeah, those buildings abandoned just like I expected them to. And it looks like I'm gonna have a fair lot more. Yeah. That may be partly due to transportation infrastructure here. So before I go, whoops, I'm going to bring this path also down here. That should give better access into the area from the metro station. And it's getting traffic. So well, I think if I were to actually put the interchange here, it'll probably help. Okay, that needs to be an exit, and that needs to be an exit. Well, if I actually build this properly, it might help too. I can just imagine everybody watching that noticed that I did that, sitting there going, "You put your ramps in the wrong way! You put your ramps in the wrong way!" Well, yes, I did. I have now put them in the right way. Now, of course, I'm sure everyone's watching me going, "Why aren't you bulldozing those abandoned buildings?" Well, there's really not much point if the replacement is going to do the same thing. So, yeah, that's why. Okay, so with this interchange here, I'm going to save the game. And then I'm going to call it a part. Okay, so that's the end of part 14 of my Neverwhere project. I don't know how many more parts I'll end up doing on here. There really isn't any point in doing it. Let's see if I can fill up all 25 tiles. Well, I guess I could do that, but that's going to get tedious in a hurry. So I don't know how many more parts I'm going to do on Neverwhere, over the next while. I may stop at part 15 or 16. I'm going to try and solve my abandonment problem in that new commercial area, and then from there I'll probably end up getting bored with Neverwhere, kind of like I did with Rockdale. So I may come back to Rockdale, actually, and see if I can sort out the big problems I had going in there, now that I have a fair notion of what those problems actually are. But still, there will be at least one more part in Neverwhere, so I hope everyone comes back for that part too, and thank you for watching.